Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Liz and this is Simply Homeschool. So today I wanted to take you guys on a homeschool room tour. If this is your first time visiting my channel, my name is Liz. I'm a homeschooling mom to two kids. One's name is Tally. She is 9 years old and in fourth grade. And then I have a son and his name is Isaiah and he is in pre-K and he just turned 5. So just to kind of tell you guys a little bit about us, we do homeschool with my sister and her two daughters, Juliana, who's in eighth grade and 13. And then we also homeschool Ariana, who's in third grade and she's 8. So we have a full house here. My sister comes every morning, well, Monday through Friday, and we school together. And we feel really blessed to be able to make these memories together and be able to share it with you guys here on YouTube. So if you're new here, welcome. If you're returning, thank you guys for coming and hanging out with me. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know if you're new. Let me know if you've been here a while. Just say hi. I love hearing from you guys and knowing who is on my channel and watching the video. I hope that you guys enjoy this video. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, you guys, so this is looking in from my kitchen into the schoolroom, and I did want to mention that this is definitely not for a minimalist homeschooler. Now, you definitely do not need a schoolroom in any way, shape, or form. This is just the way I like to do it. That's why we transformed one of our living spaces into it. I just really wanted to do it that way, so, and I'm happy I did because now we can school with my sister and nieces. But you really do not need all of this. This is just my preference, okay? And we're not all the same, and that's okay. This is basically my daughter's section here. She is 9, almost 10, and in fourth grade. So as you can see, she basically uses this cart for most of her books for her curriculum. And then she has some art stuff in there. But if you guys wanna check out our cart tour, I have that on my channel. So over here on the wall, she has her map for her geography. We just put her little history artwork on the wall there for her. Moving down to this first shelf here, she just has some suckers. If she's good, she can eat those at the end of the day or at the end of the week. We have the sharpener here on her desk. Most of the girls use that, I think. I think they all use it, actually. On this shelf here, this is her science unit that she's working through, and then she'll just pull out the folder that she's using for that week, and next to it is her science journal that she uses. And then this binder here has most of her charts, and these are charts for language arts and I believe writing and math. And then over in these two little file holders or magazine holders, we basically have her supplemental stuff and like her writing boards. She does keep her Bible here as well. But starting on this side, this is just a little folder with writing paper. She has her American Girl Feelings books here. She has an elementary math dictionary here just in case she needs help with her math and we need to look something up. These two books here are just some division workbooks, just in case she needs help with those. She has some of her work boards here. And then this is her math helper book. So this basically has a breakdown on how to do math. This has actually helped a lot. We used it from teaching textbook. I literally just printed out their lecture that the teacher does with them for each lesson. And then I spiral bound it for her. These here I purchased for over the summer. She did work through some of these, but I'm just holding on to them just in case she needs extra help. These are just some workbooks for math. We have this little Bible timeline. She has her typing for typing one. We haven't gotten into this yet. I'm hoping we get into it this year. She has this. This is just helping words for writing. She has this grammar and punctuation book. Again, she has her Bible here and then her whiteboard. And then down here, she has her little sensory toys here that she likes to play with, her pens and pencils. This is like a little garbage that she throws wrappers in. She has her bookmark and index cards here. This I actually purchased from the Dollar Tree and each of the girls painted them. These are the Bible verse cards that I created and we just put them into here for them. So they're just gonna work from the front and we'll work through the cards this way. So she has that there. She has her laptop here on this cool little stand. She also has like her little money bag. So she puts her money in here for the school store. So this stand here she uses for her schedule and some things that she has to go back on through the week. But this is her new schedule for this week. I printed it out for her. I created it and I'm actually gonna sit down with her and have her write out what she has. And then this is what she's going to put any of her homework or things she didn't get finished in so she remembers what she has to do next. So down here in the little storage shelves under her desk, we have the Bible curriculum that they have for the rest of the school year in those expanding file folders. And then these binders here and here are their next unit studies for science. They're already prepared for them. We have our book twos of our history books that I have for all of the girls down here. That will be the second part, so the second semester of school. And then in here, I honestly don't have anything yet, so that's just waiting to be filled, you guys. And then I just put Tally's cord from her computer into that little wastebasket because we let our bunnies out to play and they cannot get a hold of any cord, so I have that tucked away there. So moving right along across the way is my son's area. I did a pretty thorough video on my son's stuff, but basically this is where he sits. I have all of his worksheets in those binders there. They have little pocket folders that we go through each week with his letters, and then he has his readers for the week that go with his unit we're doing. He has this cool little calendar through Melissa and Doug that we use. His letter of the week goes on the wall along with the alphabet and the shape we're working through. We usually change the date on that, but he was playing with it last night while I was doing things. He has his little sensory ball up there. We have a little lamp for him. Underneath, I did the same thing with the cord. And then in this little drawer set here is all of like his hands-on activities that we do. And then he has his cart here. But if you guys are interested in seeing a more in-depth of what his pre-K stuff looks like, make sure you guys check out my channel. It's on there. But these are all of his Bible books that we'll read through, all of his writing things here. And then he has some Play-Doh and his suckers there. Also, I have my daughter and my youngest niece's little geography maps here for landforms. I just kind of tucked them back there because, you guys, I'm running out of room. You know, let's just be honest. Oh, my son was sitting here a little bit ago. So, okay. So looking this way, we will go this way first. So over here, this is actually my sister's printer. And this is the little trays that we use for each of the kids. So it goes youngest to oldest. So Isaiah's, Ari's, Tally's, and Juliana's. So anytime they have finished work, they stick it in there if it is not in their workbook spiral bound booklet that we prepared for them. In this first little cubby here, this is all of my son's stuff. Again, this is in his video, but this is all basically organized for his unit studies weekly. And then these are just extras that we use with him. So all of his fun stuff. And then down here is all of my niece's science kit stuff. This is purchased, I want to say it was purchased from Rainbow Resources. And this is the physical science through Apologia. So that's all organized for her to grab. And then down here, it really looks like a disaster, you guys, but I swear it's not. I swear, it's just overly packed, right? But this is all math, manipulatives, and supplements for our girls. So, that is crazy in there. But if you guys ever wanted to see the things that I have in any of these, just let me know and I'll do a video. But that by itself is a video in its own. It will take forever. Over here is my youngest niece's desk. So she is in third grade. This is her little bulletin board. The same thing, she has her map and she has her history because we do work through those subjects together. And then at her desk, she has her cart. She has it organized differently. So she has most of like her charts and manipulatives and glues and supplies and stuff on her chart. And we did that a little bit different for my daughter. And then here at her desk, she just has her little waste basket, her little pens and pencils. I think my sister purchased them, these little holders from Target, I wanna say. Again, she has the same thing basically as Tally. Each of the kids have this. I printed out her new schedule for the upcoming week. And then we have this little homework notepad for them. For them to fill out if they have homework for, you know, to continue on through the next day or later that day. She also decorated a box for her verses. She has her laptop on her stand with her headphones. And then down in her little shelf here, this is all of her books that she uses with her curriculum. She has her little Bible journal and her Bible in this little basket here. What's in her little cabinet down here? Looks like some of her supplements for history and science. She has her mouse, she has her suckers in here. That's a little container of erasers. And then she has some readers that she's going to be reading through. What else is here? So on her little pullout here that you usually use for a keyboard, this is where she keeps her workbook pages that she uses throughout the week. So that is it. Oh, and I forgot to show you guys. Above, we have our landforms map. We kept that the same, and we have our United States map, and we kept that the same as well. But below there, I have my printer and then all of our paper. I purchased that from the Dollar Tree, you guys, and it is very flimsy, but I found something that I want to purchase, and I haven't purchased it yet, but this is working out well. Because we have our regular paper on the top, we have our 32-pound paper, and then we have cardstock. So it at least keeps it separated. Now in our cubbies here, I do wanna point out that they are kind of messy, so do not judge. So in here, we just have some empty folders here. We have our money for our school store. And then these are the little tickets that we give out when they're doing good. And then in all of these little plastic containers are just like supplies for the school. Extra pencils, markers, erasers, lead, chalk, all of that good stuff. And then I just have this thing with just miscellaneous. I got over trying to organize everything, you guys. And this next one, now this one is a disaster and I'm so embarrassed to show you guys, but it is full and I just can't do too much about it. So, once I move the top layer off, it's not horribly bad, but this is just where we keep all of our supplies, our tacks, highlighters, what are they, paper clips, glues, envelopes, I don't know, just all kinds of everything, you guys, our rubber bands and stuff like that. So that is what's in here. This just has some of my little markers and crayons and pens. My zipper broke on it. We have a thing of tape in here, right here. And then we have our stapler. And these are just full of Post-its. So, that's our top two drawers. In our bottom drawers, here's more supplies with composition books, laminating pouches. We have more glue and tape and Post-its and markers and hole punchers. And then in this bottom drawer, we have all kinds of our paper. So we have, what is this? Construction paper back here, more laminating pouches, our 32-pound paper. We have colored cardstock. These, what are these? These are more laminating pouches, more paper. I think this is our cardstock. And then we have lined paper here. So a whole bunch. It's like literally, I don't know, it's just too heavy, you guys. Okay, so that is this area here. So that is what I've showed you guys so far, and my son's. Now looking over here, I'll show you this. Now this is what I prepared for our science. So this is our teacher supplies that we need for our science unit with the two younger girls. And then this is Natalia's stuff, and then this is Ari's stuff, already organized. All right, you guys, so over here on our game cabinet, we have the Christian flag and the American flag. We have our microscope. I do have to pull our other one in because we are starting on that this week. I have our little blessings sign up for fall. And then I have our little decorative scarecrows that we used for our first day of school for our tea time. Now, if you guys have watched my videos, you know that we lost our uncle. And so this was his clock. So now it is in our schoolroom. And when he was sick, he had this. Let me see if I could. There we go. He had this little origami bird in his flower arrangement. And there was a huge discussion that we had, myself and him together, about this. It was pretty funny. But when he passed, my mom saved this for me and brought it to me. So, it has a lot of meaning, and I love it. And I love that it's in here with us. So that's it for the top here. Now, this is our game cabinet. We have all of our games and our hands-on things that I do with my son as well. On the top shelf here, we have all of the games that our older kiddos will be using throughout the year. And then the last three shelves, you guys, are basically for my son. I have been collecting this stuff for years, so this was not just purchased. So the second shelf here actually has some of the things that we use with the older girls, like these are for them, that's for them. These two puzzles they're going to be using, but all of the other stuff you see here are things that I'm going to be using with my son, as well as this here. We've been using these. This was put in backwards. That's gonna drive me crazy. Let me just change it right now. So all of these are my son's games, and then down here are some hands-on games and just different puzzles. We have our mats here that we're gonna be using with geography and with my son's like dinosaurs and stuff. And then under there, I just have my microscope container. So that's it there. Moving on over to here, you guys. These are my sister and myself's carts because we do not have a desk. So this is basically my sister's cart. And this is my cart. So my desk and my sister's desk. Don't mind the cords down there. It's the extension cords for the laptops. Okay, so over here, you guys, is my niece's area and our little library. Now, don't mind our TV stand, you guys. I really debated on taking that down, but I'm like, okay, if we ever turn it back into a family room, am I really gonna wanna have the hassle of putting that big old thing back up there? And the answer was no. So we're basically just putting our posters here. It's like just hanging. This isn't supposed to be there. I forgot to even take this down for this video, but this isn't supposed to be here. It should just be her President of the United States for civics. And then that is her geography map because she's actually working through geography with us. She doesn't need it in any way, shape, or form, you guys, except for the fact or reason that she wanted to do it with us as a group. Okay, you guys, so it's gonna be a little bit darker on this side just because the light is glaring through and it's making it really washed out. So this is basically my 13-year-old niece's desk, her little area over here. Starting here, she just has her little waste basket, her pencil holder. This is just one of those like relaxing, you know, colored oil things. I don't even know what they're called. She has her schedules here. And then this is her verse that we worked through last week. I'm not sure what she has on there. Oh, Roman numerals. It's like a little cheat sheet, I guess. I don't know. And then this is her little box that she painted for all of her verses. She usually has it tucked right underneath there. She has her little pencil holder, her laptop on her laptop stand. And then this is basically where she keeps all of her curriculum books. These are the things that she works with pretty much every day or every week. Her Bible's in there, her thesaurus, some of our geography books, some supplements that we're using to go along with our curriculum. And then over here to the left, she has her cart. And this is basically how her sister's cart is. She has most of her supplies there. I did not do a video on her cart or my other niece's cart. So if you guys wanna see videos on that, let me know and I will put them together for you guys. All right, you guys, so now we are over at our little library shelf. We have our American flag and Christian flag. We have our Jesus picture. We have the infuser with the oils up there. It's actually going right now with peace and calming because I feel like I need peace and calming sometimes. Here on the top shelf. Now I did organize our shelves according to subject basically. So let me just show you an overview of what it looks like. That, is it blurry? I hope it's not blurry, you guys. I'm still trying to figure out how my settings work best for you. Okay, so over here we have all of their nature books. Again, I have a picture. I actually printed these out from Gather Round's Easter and I framed them because I just love them. I thought they were so beautiful. So I went ahead and did that. On this side is all of the read alouds that we're gonna be doing together that goes along with all of our subjects, science, history, Bible, everything, you guys. There's some Christmas books in here that we're gonna read together. This goes along with our Bible. Now these are mine. I have these over here because this is usually where I sit when I do my Bible for myself. And I have my studies here as well. But these are all having to do with read alouds that we are gonna be doing for the year. Here on the second shelf, I have our globe here, and then I have all of our readers that the kids can do on their own. There's some things in here that are biography, some are just fun reads. Some of these I plan on doing as read alouds as well. They're just here because they don't really sit in with our actual curriculum. The ones up there I got to actually go along with our curriculum, but these are just more like fun read alouds to do. And then we have all of our who was here. All right, so moving on down to our third shelf. This has coding and literature and fun like activity books to do for writing. We have our dictionaries and our thesauruses, encyclopedias. And then over here we have all of our Christian heroes, their devotionals, and some of our Bible books. Over here on the fourth shelf, we have our geography type books, national parks, things like that. Oh look, my niece just shoved that there. This is actually Julian's. She had to read this last year. How funny, she shoved it in right there. So this again, this is all like natural wonders and things like that, geography. We have our little wild animals of the world postcards. I plan on using these with our mammals science. And then we have a history set back there from Usborne. These here are just kind of random, you guys. So we have all about feelings and feelings management type books. We have math books. We have some workbooks here. And then all of these, you guys, we are using to go along with our book unit studies that we're doing this year. These here are for history, and then this is supposed to be for our health. I'm thinking these we may not get to this year for health. I don't know, we'll see, but I will definitely be doing unit studies or book studies on these. I actually started them, but I haven't been able to continue with them. These are more of our history book studies. And then down here on the last shelf, we have all of our science type books. Over here on this side over here, we're basically not using through this year, but everything from, okay, we're probably not getting to the owls. We were supposed to do it last year. We didn't get to it because we were all sick, but I'm gonna see how we're gonna fit that in. But we are gonna do that in the future at some point. But all of these here, these we're gonna be using for science. So I think it goes actually up to here. These are all the things that we'll be using for science. So that is basically how our little library works, how we have it set up. Okay, so again, this is Juliana's. And then over here, I'm so sorry about the lighting. Now, this little stand here, I move around constantly. It doesn't just sit in front of my doors here. But in the top portion, I have all of my binding, like my spirals and the tools I need. I also have these spiral, because these are my ProClicks, but this is one of my spirals, and the box for this is actually in the garage because it's huge and I just don't have the space for it because I had to buy it in bulk. And then this one here is our ink for the printers, our cutters, our laminator machine. And then I always have a hard time getting this drawer open. This I actually have the girls roll out. It's like a foam, I don't know what it is, you guys. It's like for your cabinets, like the cabinet liners, but I have them put it on our bench on our picnic table in the backyard because it has splinters and I don't want them to get a splinter in their butt. So that is that, you guys. And then I have some cords here. These are our little clear pocket holders. And then we just have more paper, you guys. A huge amount of paper. I don't know what to do with it, so. But that is our homeschool room, you guys. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if there's anything you guys want to see more in depth, and I will be sure to make a video for you guys. You guys be safe, be blessed, and I will see you next time. Bye.
What if the world had more of your smile? What if the wind could spread your love? What if your sweetness could reach everyone? There'd be no wars.